In this case study, we'll understand how to evaluate a lease proposal and compare it with borrow and buy option and take a decision. Melanie Company is considering the acquisition of new machine with an operating life of 3 years. The new machine could be leased for 3 payments of $55,000 payable annually in advance. Alternatively, the machine could be purchased for $160,000 using a bank loan at a cost of 8% per year. If the machine is purchased, Melanie Company will incur maintenance cost of $8,000 per year, payable at the end of each year of operation. The machine would have residual value of $40,000 at the end of its 3-year life. Melanie Company's production manager estimates that if maintenance routines were upgraded, the new machine could be operated for a period of 4 years with maintenance cost increasing to $12,000 per year, payable at the end of each year of operation. If operated for 4 years, the machine's residual value would fall to $11,000. Taxation should be ignored. Required. Question number 1. Assuming that new machine is operated for a 3-year period, evaluate whether Melanie Company should use leasing or borrowing as a source of finance. Question number 8.2. Using a discount rate of 10%, calculate equivalent annual cost of purchasing and operating the machine for both 3 years and 4 years and recommend which replacement interval should be adopted. Question B will take up in next session. Even question A part 2 also will be taking up only in the next session. Okay? Yeah. We'll get started. So here, they have 2 choices in front of them. One is, instead of buying, go for lease only. The other one is buy. But for buying, they should borrow. And when they borrow, the cost is $160,000 and interest rate is 8%. And there will be maintenance cost. And at the end of 3-year life, the machine can be sold for $40,000. Okay. So first, we'll look at lease option, which is simple. Because 3 payments, $55,000. And all the payments are in the beginning. So in year 0, year 1, year 2 payments will happen. And these payments present value have to be arrived at by discounting them at the rate of 8%. And by doing this, we get to know what is the present value of lease option. Let's do that. Here we have, okay, the question abridged form. Yeah. Assuming that new machine is operated for 3-year period, let's evaluate whether they should go for leasing option or borrowing option. First, we'll evaluate the lease. So, I'm going to take year 0, 1, 2, 3. And if it is lease, what is the annual lease rent? It is given in the question. It is $55,000 and it happens in the beginning of the year. So, it happens at year 0, lease payment $55,000. That is now. Year 1, year 2. These are all outflows. So, indicated within brackets. Now, if you want to find the present value of this, it has to be discounted at a rate. And question says it is 8%. Okay, so look at this. Cost is 8%. So we'll use this 8% as the discount rate. We'll bring them here. Present value factor at 8%. For year 0, it will be 1. For year 1, it is 1 divided by 1.08 to the power 1. And for year 2, it is 0.857. Now we'll find present value. Simple. Take the lease payment, multiply with PV factor, and you get these numbers. And if you can add all the 3, that is, if you add all the 3, what you get? You get the present value of lease option. And it is 153,065. 153,065. This is present value of cost if this company is going for lease option. Alternatively, they can go for borrow and buy option also. Let's do that. Borrow and buy option, and this is the table. If they are going to borrow and buy, what is the cost? Look at here. The machine could be purchased for $160,000, right? Okay, so we'll bring that here. Initial cost, $160,000. It's an outflow. Then, the machine can also be sold for $40,000 at the end of its 3-year life, right? We'll capture that. So, this is the residual value, and this is what we are going to get at the end of 3rd year. So, residual value is 40,000. Then there is also an annual maintenance cost. How much? Here you have $8,000 per year. We'll capture that. It's an outflow. maintenance year 1 8000, year 2 year 3. Okay, now we'll capture all this. The total year 0, it's an outflow of $160,000, year 1 outflow of 8000, year 2 outflow of 8000, year 3 inflow of 40,000 and outflow of 8000, so net of 32,000. And now these cash flows have to be converted as present values by multiplying with the discount factor, and discount rate is 8%. So 1 divided by 1.08 to the power 1, 2, 3 will give you the discount factors. Unfortunately, I missed that in the presentation. Okay, but still you can do that calculation here. Very simple. 8000 multiplied by 1 divided by 1.08 to the power 1, power 2, power 3. And that will give you the present value. As far as year 0 is concerned, it is multiplied by 1. So same figure. 8000 multiplied by 1 divided by 1.08 to the power 1, you get 7408. To the power 2, you get 6856. And power 3, you get 25408. Okay, so you have 3 outflows and 1 inflow. Outflows are indicated in brackets, inflow positive. And let's get that. It is 148,856. So if they go for borrow and buy option, what they commit or what they spend or what is their cash outflow in present value language, it is 148,856. Now we have to take a decision. The decision is go for borrow and buy, because borrow and buy offers the cheapest present value cost, because leasing option, the present value is greater than this 148,856. Okay, so borrow and buy offers the cheapest present value cost. So this machine should be financed by borrowing.